Hey everybody, it's Matt Maher with Gospel Reflection for the second Sunday of Lent. This is from the Gospel of Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, "This is my beloved son. Listen to him." Suddenly looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. This is the word of the Lord. This gospel to me stands out a lot because it doesn't really seem consistent with how Jesus reveals himself. Usually he's hanging out with tax collectors and prostitutes, and he chooses fishermen as disciples, not Pharisees. Yet there is this one moment where he's up on a mountain, and usually he goes on mountains to escape people, to be by himself, but he takes some of his closest followers with him, and all of a sudden this supernatural event happens that feels like a Marvel movie in the middle of this sort of like very gritty word became flesh, like man of no reputation, suffering servant kind of Jesus. All of a sudden he's glowing like Captain Marvel or something. And it feels just so inconsistent with how Christ is revealing himself. But I think it's this healthy reminder that as approachable as Jesus is to us, he is still God and he is still glorious. And even in the midst of his approachability and his willingness to journey with 12 believers and sleep on the grass and walk with them as they're eating on the Sabbath, or picking up dirt and rubbing it into a man's eyes with spit and healing him of his blindness, or going to a girl who had fallen asleep, going to a dead body and breathing on it and saying, "Come alive." That same God has this moment where he is shining brighter than the sun. And his clothes look so white, there's no bleach on earth that could get him that white. That's such a great detail, right? But Peter's response of saying, "This is so amazing, we should just camp out here," is very much a human response. Because those moments in our life where we encounter the glory of God, we do and everything is great, and God is brighter than the sun. We want to stay in those moments. But Jesus very quickly is like, "No, we got to go back down the mountain." Because so much of the experience of life isn't that. In some ways, I feel like maybe we're not made for it. Maybe we can't handle it 24/7 in our humanity. So Christ gives us these glimpses and these moments of his glory because it's all we can handle. And then we walk back down into the mundaneness of our life. And just like the apostles, we question, what does it mean to live as though Christ is risen from the dead? These are all things that we can reflect on, like I said, in the season of Lent as we're journeying with Christ. And I hope maybe this week you can ask, what are the mountaintops that you've been grateful for, but what are the valleys that you need to walk into with Jesus? Have a good week.